Overview to Matplotlib architecture. When we look at any graph in Matplotlib, we can easily recognize that figure is the center of all operations inside. Before it, the programmer builds subplots and axes on top of the figure, and the chart on top of axes, while the figure is totally segregated from rendering process and how to display that to the end users on their own platform or operating system. So, to create fairly sophisticated features and logic into the figures while keeping both directions, the programmer codes and the backends or the output devices, relatively simple, Matplotlib was developed in three separated layers. While all articles use the stack terminology to describe the construction of this architecture of three layers on top of each other, I prefer to use that workflow style, and I will show it to you again in details in the summary section in the next video. Each layer that sits on top of another layer knows only how to talk to the layer below it, but the lower layer is not aware of the layers above it. That limitation in the interfaces and kind of encapsulation of all Matplotlib functionality and features in three separated layers obtained many mutual benefits. Number one, for programmers, where they have the same interface API to Matplotlib, no matter the changes that are consistently done inside. Number two, for the end users, where users would not observe the changes across different platforms. Number three, and finally, for Matplotlib developers, where development and debugging are seamless. Now, let's look at the functionality of each layer and the embedded elements.